I'm going to take this off. Now, I've done this before and started with the other side each time, but it's always been a hassle. So I'm going to start this side. I'm going to tape it up. On this side, you have to tape your projects. If you don't tape your project, your drips are going to be something that will ruin your project. If it's salvageable, it's going to take you forever to clean it up. Normally I like to cut this to make sure it's cleaned up around the edges, but I'm not going to worry about it too much. Now I'm going to take one of my little bottles. I always say that dun dun, because I like listening to Mexican music. Latino, in case you haven't told by skin. And at the end of every mariachi song or cumbia song, you always hear the last two trumpet notes, dun dun. So we always say dun dun. Alright, so it's backed off. I think I'm going to need about 4 ounces. I'm going to mix that up, get the colors separated, and we'll start pouring. I'd like it to be a lighter color, though. I'll think about it while I'm mixing up. You guys, kick back. I'll be with you in a second. So I went ahead and mixed up 4 ounces. And decided on a color. Before I do that, let's put these up. Turn off the heater at my back. And then I've put in green interference from Let's Resin. And what I'm gonna do, is mix this up in a little cup. make sure all the little granules are dissolved. Push it against the sides. And if I were using it in this cup, I'd let it sit for a second and then do a second mix. But what I'm gonna do is pour the whole thing into my main pot. Scrape that off. And then mix that all up. Okay. Now, I'm going to start around the edge. I'm going to start around the edge. Let's just go with that. I don't want it to fall on the outside, but I'm not very good at straight lines. First thing I'm going to do is spread it out on the ledge. If you guys at home are doing this, I'm sure you'll have much better luck with your initial pour on the edge. My tremors are a little difficult to work with, so I don't really beat myself up for making a mess. Okay. Let's hit it with the heat gun. First, wipe my hands off. I see hair. Can't have that now, can we? There. Now, all I'm going to do is let that cure overnight. What is that? Goodness. Okay. One thing you could do, if you like, just see how that was when I touched it. You can make designs in it if you wanted. can do whatever you want. And I'm just gonna cover that up. I keep seeing little hairs. And that's really bothering me. There. I'm gonna go ahead and cover this up, and we will do the second part tomorrow. Okay, so we're back. It's the next day. It's cured. The lines aren't visible that I drew in there, but that's okay. If I would have waited longer and let it set more and then did the lines, yeah, it would have shown up. But I'm happy with it. This is why we take the back off the drips. So now we have to remove that tape. When that happens. There's a much easier way to do this. Why am I being stupid? Now let's try it. The resin isn't stuck to the board, the tape is. So I'm just giving a little pry up, not coming in contact with the wood. I'm sticking my knife into the actual resin and peeling it up. Heat it up and it will come off, but I always forget to heat it up. Now I'm going to mix up some resin. Oh, I can't yet. We have to tape off the other side. Crap. Okay. This is where it gets tricky. So I'm going to start here. We have to conform the bends in the tray right here. I want to get it closer. Get it as close to the edge as possible, but I don't want an overhang. Take our little stick and burnish it. A fancy word for stick it to it. Okay, now we're all set. So I'm gonna mix up the resin and we'll get to our next step. Okay, I went ahead and mixed up some resin. And the colors I'm gonna be using are grass green, metallic gold, and brilliant gold mixed in the same cup. Interference green and black marble. And, oh yeah, and Castin craft black. Put that over there. And the first thing I'm gonna do, stir up my colors. And I'm gonna go ahead and pour the black on first. And just let that pool and degas and do whatever it's got to do. Put my cup over there. And get a little thingy, because thingy is the professional term for it. Lick it towards the edge. It's okay if it runs over. It's going to run over once we start applying the other colors. For now, we're just letting it find its own level. Here we go. Okay. We'll let that sit. Now we mix up our other colors. Interference green. Sit black marble. Remember, I reuse my cups, that's why they look like there's another color in them once they harden. They make great mixing cups, leveling stands, whatever you want. Let's see, which one is this? This is the green grass? No, this is the color shift green. Yes. I'm stirring fast, but because the stick is so small, it's not really whipping up a lot of bubbles. And this is the green grass. Grass green, pardon me. I had to read the bottle. Okay, and gold. I didn't mix up too much gold because it takes over. You don't need very much for this project. I'll admit this is the first time I'm doing this with green. It's the same one, same type of design I used on my video for Stranded Ink, their order tray. I think our table's crooked. Say that because over here it's empty. Looks like mica. Well, that's okay. We'll use it. All right, now. Make sure that's leveled properly. And then, what are we gonna do? Quick mix again. Let's start with black. Put that aside. Next up, we're gonna do interference green. Then, let's do the color shift. Green. Now the grass green. I should start doing lives. That way you guys could tell me what to do. And the last thing we're gonna do is the gold. Remember I said we have to use this real sparingly. I think gold is the only one I'm not going to do the lines behind with. So now that that's done, heat gun. Which direction do I want? Well, let's just do this and break up the lines. I am pleased to say that it is looking better than I was hoping. Ugh, my table is wobbling. Did you guys see that? I can't seem to fix it. Let's see. Let's put this here. There. I still think that's too much gold, so. Okay, what do you guys think? I think it looks good. One more blast. What the heck is that on my project? If you have to dip into it like this, pull up and away so that at least the design won't be affected too much. I love it. I'm gonna go ahead and cover it. And we will do the next step in the morning. I love it. Hey you guys, okay, so this is how it came out. What do you think? Now, it's hard to tell with the camera here, but the floating metal mica, and it really creates depth. You can't really tell, and I wish you could. I like the way it came out. It does look very 3D, you guys. I'm pleased. So what we gotta do is remove the goodies from the back. There's a couple little pieces that I need to get off, but I could get that off later. That's just annoying. Okay. And some over here. Rolling tray on one side. And when people come over, hang it up on the wall. Get a little piece of art. You could even put a fake clock face or a saying or whatever you want, but I'm gonna leave it blank just because I like it like that. Not bad. Alright, you guys, I hope you had fun watching, and I'll see you on the next video.